we've got a lot of dead LEDs. So I've just been fixing this light, which had all of the LEDs pretty much knackered and not working. So I'm going to do another one. Hopefully you guys will find it interesting. That's the light off. Right, we're going to take the lens off now. Get all this sealant out of here. Easy. Thought it'd be damp, but it's actually dry in there. Next, I'm going to hook up a 12 volt power supply to this, and we'll see which ones aren't working. Clearly see these. That's really bright. There's two down the bottom here basically that aren't coming on. So we're going to replace both of those now. The easiest way I found of doing these is to snip the legs first, and then just force that off, force the top of the LED off, because this is soldered onto the back for heatsink purposes, so it's really hard to get off in one piece. Let's take that off, get the extractor going. And yeah, a big soldering iron helps. Easy. So we want to clean that up now. And use some solder wick. And some flux on. Get the remains of those legs off as well. Just wipe that off. Yeah. Nice and clean. So the new one. Pop a bit of compound paste on. There's any left in the chamber. Just a little bit. Now this needs to be orientated because they are polarity sensitive. There's a little hole you'd see on these. Yeah, at the top here. A little hole. And that is the neg should have made a note of this, but these are in a row. So the neg for this one is down this end. Neg pos, so this will be the neg hit, and it says on there actually. Nice and easy. Squeeze that one there. Make sure it's lined up in the box. Soldered on that. I'm going to do the other one now as well. So we've done those two now. And I'm going to put some electrical solvent cleaner on. Just clean up the flux with a toothbrush. I'm not going to go too nuts because I don't want to wash all the thermal paste out. Just blow that off an airline now. That'll do. Let's plug this in, see if it works. There we go. All working. Next thing, tidy all this up. I'll get the lens back on. So the old sealant looks like plastic, but it isn't. Get the wire brush around that. Just so the new sealant's got something to go against rather than just sitting on corrosion, which isn't going to seal very well. Airline and blow all that out. So we're going to use CT1, probably not the best, because if it's ever got to come apart again, it won't. So just going to put a bead around here. To make sure all the moisture is out of this lens, there is some in there. You can see it, so I'm just going to blow that out with the airline again. That's it, good to go. And he goes one way, make sure it's right aligned. The air escaping out of that. Alright, so that's back together. We'll just connect up the power, make sure it works. Yeah. Sweet. Let's get it back on the truck. All working. Ah, that one's next, I think. Yeah. Beats buying new ones.